Alright, hello everyone. Magandang araw sa inyong lahat. And I am recording this lecture for the benefit of my research students. So shout out sa inyo. Shout out sa Eratosthenes, sa Archimedes, sa Aristotle, and Tesla. Okay, so hello, hello, hello. We're gonna be talking about APA citation style. No? So I gave you an exam. I gave you the slides, the PowerPoint presentation, pero syempre iba pa rin yung merong konting discussion, no? I was a little busy, so eto, gawa na lang natin ng YouTube video. That way you can watch this until you are confident enough that you have understood the concept. Anyway, napakasimple lang naman ito, no? APA citation style. So first, let's have a look at our lesson objectives, okay? What exactly are we aiming to learn? So after you go through this material, you should have an understanding kung bakit importante ang citation. Ano ba yan? Para saan ba yan? Bakit natin ginagawa yan? And also, you're supposed to learn kung paano ba tayo nagsa-cite ng ibang research. Kasi there are several ways that you can do it, no? That's why I was emphasizing that it's important for you to learn how to properly cite other researches. Because it will make you a more versatile writer. And also, again, specifically, we're going to be working with the APA format, okay? And giving credit to your cited authors. Ano naman yan? Given na naman yan, APA talaga yung gagamitin natin, no? So this is for humanities and STEM. Like I mentioned before, ang APA, ang gumagamit niyan kadalasan, dati ay mga humanities students, humanities teachers, and those in social sciences. Pero recently, yung mga STEM, the field of STEM, nagsuswitch na rin sila sa APA format, no? So let me just move my camera. Okay. Anyway, so yeah, let's start. So let's see. Okay, so first of all, let's just talk about the concept involved in our lesson. So what exactly are we doing this for? Well, whenever you are writing a research paper, it's inevitable, hindi maiiwasan na meron kang mga imemention na ibang mga research papers, kasi unang-una meron tayong tinatawag na chapter 2 related literature. But more than that, you have to understand there's basically nothing new under the sun, no? So kung ano man yung mga problem na may isip nyong gawing topic for your research, chances are somebody before has already looked into it. So you're just building upon the works of other people. So yun nga, inevitable na meron ka ma-i-mention na ibang mga research papers, meron kang i-mention na mga articles, mga books. So, in doing so, you have to make sure that you are giving proper credit. Otherwise, you might be accused of plagiarism. So, when you are giving credit to another author whom you mention in your paper, yun yung tinatawag natin na citation, no? From the word cite. You are citing them, okay? You are mentioning them, and you are giving them proper credit, okay? And again, we're doing all this because, you know, we're avoiding plagiarism, and also because we are expanding the scope of the literature through our own research. So next slide, let's see. Teka. Okay, pagdating sa APA citation style, just remember that there are two elements. In-text citation, tapos yung tinatawag natin na reference list. Okay, so what exactly is the in-text citation? So, ayan yung definition. Teka, gagawin ko ulit yung ano ko dito. Okay, so there's the definition. You can read it for yourself. Pero basically, kapag sinabi nating in-text citation, ayan yung binanggit mo, yung isang author, tapos yung isang research paper, within your sentences doon sa sinusulat mo, doon sa thesis mo, no? So yun yung in-text citation. So you're typing your introduction, for example, no? Ginagawa mo yung introduction mo, tapos you mentioned a specific paper or a specific work by an author, yun yung tinatawag natin na in-text citation. So that's the first element. Tapos, lahat ng in-text citation mo, mag-a-appear yan later on, dun sa last part ng thesis nyo, dun sa tinatawag natin na reference list, no? So yun yung isa pang element. So basically, lahat ng i-mention nyo na mga authors, mga writers, articles, journals, whatever, all of those things will be appearing alphabetically later on in the research dun sa likod, dun sa tinatawag natin na reference list. Yun yung term na ginagamit ng APA. No? So remember, in-text citation, and then later on, sa reference list, makikita niyo siya. So, ano lang yan eh. Simple lang naman yung concept dyan eh. Ito, halimbawa, if you are writing a similar research paper and you wish to cite my research, you will need to write Viray 2009. For example, Viray 2009. So, this is the in-text citation. Ngayon, yung Viray 2009, kung binabasa siya, halimbawa, ng isang, well, if someone's reading your work, and then nabasa yung Viray 2009, tapos gusto niyang i-check kung ano ba yung title ng work ng Viray na to, kung sino man yan. Pupunta siya sa likod ng research mo, i-check niya yung reference list, tapos makikita niya, it's alphabetically listed. Pagdating niya dun sa Viray 2009, lalabas yung title ng research, tapos lalabas dun kung, if it's a book, lalabas yung publishing house, if it's part of a series of editions, lalabas kung pang ilang edition to. So ganun, no? Yun yung basically yun yung purpose ng reference list. You mention an author and the year of publication sa in-text citation, and then more information is provided pagdating dun sa reference list. So that's the concept. No? Ganun lang siya kasimple sa APA. Tapos ayan, na-mention ka na yan. So let's go to the next slide. Okay, so these are just some examples of what in-text citations will look like, no? What they will look like. So yan, basahin nyo, i-pause nyo muna yung video if you need to. Just take note, no, yung first name ng author pagdating sa reference list, you don't have to spell it out. Just the last name, first name as an initial, and then the year of the publication, tapos yung title of the research. This is how it would look. This is what it would look like kapag ano, kapag thesis yung sinasite nyo, the thesis of someone else. Kasi you can do that if you have access to the previous output ng mga naunang batches sa inyo and you want to cite them, that's what it would look like. No? Excuse me. Ngayon, ito medyo self-explanatory naman. No? Pinapakita ko lang sa inyo sa part na to kung ano yung itsura, nung, kung ano yung magiging format exactly, depending on the type of reference that you are citing. No? So, itong mga ipapakita nating slides na kasunod, ito yung sa references. Okay? Pero yung in-text citation, tandaan nyo, last name, tapos date of publication lang lagi. No, kapag walang date to publication, ND for no date, ganun lang siya kasimple. So one important thing, kapag sinusulat natin yung title, mapapansin nyo, lagi siyang naka-italicize. Italicize meaning nakatagilid, no? Control I lang yan. Highlight nyo lang sa word, tapos control I, ganun lang siya kadali. Ano pa ba? Etong URL, kapag meron kayong mostly sa inyo, malamang gagawin online references. And that's completely fine. Given the pandemic, you're not really expected to go around magpunta ng mga library. So most likely, everyone's references will be online. So that's completely fine. But please review kung paano yung format nun, no? So ayan, last name, title ng ebook in this case. Tapos, yung URL, Uniform or Universal Resource Locator, ayan yung nasa address bar sa internet browser nyo. Kocopy nyo lang yan, tapos ipipaste nyo dun sa Word document. So, i-yan nyo lang, i-review nyo lang tong part na to, tapos, ayan, ito just a few minor points. So, mga technicalities na lang to eh. When there are two or more authors, use the ampersand yata ang tawag dito kung di ako nagkakamali. Instead of the word end, yun yung gamitin natin, yung symbol for end. Nasa ano niya yan. That's number 7, shift 7. Okay, ngayon, pagdating sa, meron kasi mga works na ang daming authors, no? Kapag 6 or more authors, gamitin nyo na lang yung first surname, yung first author sa surname, tapos et al. Et al stands for and everyone else, and group, no? So, ayun. Kapag 3 to 5 authors, the first time that you mention the authors, so you write everyone's surnames, and then yung mga kasunod, yung last name na lang ng first author. Yung first author, normally, siya yung pinakang nag-abala dun sa pinakang nakakuha ng credit for the research. So sa inyo, ayan yung leader nyo. Kung sino yung pinakang leader ng grupo sa thesis, siya yung first author. So medyo that's a place of glory and of course responsibility. Not everyone is willing to be research leaders. So, ito, medyo importante to. Parang maraming nalito dito dun sa examen. Mentioning in text versus not mentioning in text. Concept dito eh, and I want you to understand this. Kasi this will help you write in a more versatile manner. Versatile means mas marami kayong paraan ng pagsusulat, no? Hindi katulad nung mga ibang estudyante na puro according to this author or according to that researcher, according to, that's not the only way that you can cite a reference, no? So, mentioning in text versus not mentioning in text. Actually, medyo, ang haba kasi nung ginagamit nung APA, no? We're just gonna call it textual versus parenthetical. So, ganito lang naman yan kasimple. Textual or mentioning in text, kapag yung apelido ng author ay hindi naka-parenthesis. Meaning, it's part of the text itself. You wrote it like the examples I have here. So, Viray argued in his study that there were no differences, okay? And then so on and so forth. So, dito, you are making a direct statement, a direct citation. Tapos, pinapakita mo lang yung, well, in-include yung year dun sa first tsaka sa third example within parenthesis, pero yung name of the author itself ay walang parenthesis. So, this is a textual citation or an author mentioned in text citation. Pay attention to the second example. In a study published in 2009, Viray found that both high performers and low performers, and then, you know, the sentence goes on. So, ang point lang dito is, this is a result of your own composition. Hindi mo lang kinopy-paste yung nakita mo from another research. Kasi ganun yung nangyayari sa kadalasan eh. According to Viray, comma, tapos quotation mark, blah, 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 blah. But there are so many ways that you can cite an author. So, again, this is textual. Okay, author mentioned in text. So, ano naman yung author not mentioned in text? So, huwag kayong malito. Author not mentioned in text, pero the author is mentioned in parenthesis. So, ito yung example natin. Academic dishonesty, well, you can read the rest of it. And then, close it up in parenthesis, Viray 2009. Ganun lang siya kasimple. If you see the name of the author in parenthesis, then it's parenthetical, meaning the author is not mentioned in text. The author is mentioned in parenthesis. And again, knowing the difference between them will help give you more ways of writing citations. So, paraphrasing, ibang discussion pa yon. Pero yun, no? Sana naintindihan natin. Huwag kayong malito dun sa dalawa. Intindihin niyo mabuti. Ulitin yung video kung kailangan. Basahin mabuti yung mga slides. And yun lang naman. I'm actually concerned ako sa time. Hanggang 15 minutes lang kasi. So, have a good day and good luck with the exam. So that's it. Thank you.